Hey, what's good, Magic Gang? Welcome back to Magic Got the Tea. All right, oof, do I have the tea today? Okay, if you are new to my channel, welcome. I am Magi. I am a psychic medium and I am the deliverer, the messenger of truth and light here. Okay, anything that has been hidden in your life, I will always expose. And these readings here in my channel feel very personal. I always make sure I deliver details and signs, synchronicities that will allow you to know if this reading is for you or if it isn't. If this one particularly isn't today, make sure you check out my other videos, okay? There are tons, thousands of videos that I've posted before. Don't forget to hit the notification bell, okay? So that you know when I'm coming up with a tea again. Stay tuned, all right? So you are withholding a very powerful ability. It's the download that I received from your spirit guides, ancestors, universe, okay? Yes, you. You are withholding a very powerful ability and it's time for you to use this gift, okay? It's time to use this gift. I'm gonna write that down. Time to use this gift. You can comment that in the comments that down below. It's time for me to use my gift because there's something very powerful inside of you that you're not using. And it's like, why aren't you? This was given to you, gifted to you so that you can unlock this key, unlock this power and show the world or use it for, you know, your best interests. Let's look into what this powerful ability is. But I'm getting like, you're holding back. You're more powerful than you give yourself credit for. And it's time to stop holding back, okay? Don't let this scare you. You were giving this gift so that you can guide and heal others, okay? Now, I'm gonna open up my notebook because I'm hearing you need to take notes, okay? So as you're watching this video, guys, make sure you take notes. If you feel guided to it, if you feel this message is for you, okay? The number 11 is coming through. Your birthday could be on November or 11th of a month. I just saw an orb pass by. So that is already telling me that you have a gift and ability to communicate with spirits, okay? This gift that you are withholding could be this clairvoyant, clairaudient, where it's like you may know or feel that you are psychic, but you don't, like you're not using this gift, okay? You have a gift here to communicate with spirit, okay? I'm hearing spirit communication. This tells me mediumship abilities, okay? You are a medium. You are a psychic. You can communicate with the dead, with your ancestors, okay? So pay attention at these times because I am getting there are spirits that are trying to communicate with you, good spirits, okay? You could be seeing yellow orbs around you. You could be seeing hawks or dreaming about hawks. This is also a sign that this is your reading and that you do have the ability to communicate with spirits. I'm also getting here that you are a seer or a dream interpreter, okay? I'm getting dream interpretation. I'm writing these down. I'm also taking notes. I want to know what kind of abilities my collective, my subscribers have here and my newbies as well, okay? So you can see through the illusion. You can see through the veils. You may be connected to dragons, particularly here. I'm seeing yellow, okay? The color yellow, yellow dragons, yellow dress, yellow orbs. Let me know how that resonates with you. Your birthday could be on August 11th or November 8th, path life number 8 or 11. You are a dream walker. So there's a gift that you have as a lucid dreamer. And if you feel you are a lucid dreamer, meaning you can actively dream and take control of the entire dream, manipulate it, create it however you want it, because you've become aware that you are dreaming, I am being called to show you, which I guess I will use it in this reading as well, my very own oracle deck, the Chosen Ones 144. Okay, these were made by me and spirit and my ancestors. And they're telling me that you need to buy this deck, especially if you are awakening from your sleep and you feel like you are a lucid dreamer. If you don't know what this is, make sure you do your research as well. Like I'm saying, take notes, okay? So you have the ability here to communicate with spirit, mediumship, dream interpretation, and you are a lucid dreamer or a dream walker, okay? I'm also getting dream walker. So with the dream walker, I'm getting the vision that you are able to walk into other people's dreams, okay? Maybe you do not know this, but you see it. It happens to you when you're dreaming or people call you or text you or message you and they say, hey, you were in my dreams last night and you were healing me, or you were rescuing me or you were doing something, okay? Whatever. It's like you can help other people break out of illusions. Yeah, you are a dream walker. You can walk into other people's dreams, okay? Many have already told you that, or you can already feel that. Again, I'm being also called, you could be seeing a Heron or white orbs as well. It's like you can see orbs. That's how you see spirits, okay? You could also be very good at playing chess. You might have won an award here at chess because you're very good at strategizing, at making moves. You're very strategic. I'm getting Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy here. You could be 30 years old. You also have the ability here to speak to fairies, okay? You are connected to fairies and they are connected to you. You have the ability to write here, channel, direct messages, okay? So again, you could be very psychic or a messenger of some sort here where you write and you receive downloads. You could even speak to other entities and you're channeling messages here. This could happen in your sleep or your waking life. You have the ability to write as well. It's just the way that you write is very creative. You may be into fantasy writing or you writing your spiritual ascension, the things you go through. There's something unique. It's like you, when you write, you create your destiny. You're able to manifest what you desire when you write it down. So maybe even if you're just writing your desires in your journal, this is a very good way to manifest because you actually make it come to life. I'm getting like you can write a character down and you make this character come to life, or you make this idea come to life. So comment that down below. I am a medium. I am a dream interpreter. Whatever skill you think I am already saying and you're connecting with, say those with I am. I am a lucid dreamer. Okay, I am connected to fairies. I am an amazing writer. If you are a writer, a poet, a lyricist, whatever this is for you, okay? I'm definitely getting you have a certain unique connection with dragons here for sure. You could be dreaming with dragons. You are connected to the dragon's blood. Dragons and Zeus or lightning, whatever you're believing here, this is what I'm channeling. Okay, my love, you pick up whatever comes to you as well. But dragons have hidden treasure. So there is a lot hidden inside of you that you're not actively connecting with. But your dreams are trying to tell you something. I'm getting you're somebody that's full of surprises. Because you're always awakening new abilities inside of you. You're somebody very versatile. Okay, you can comment that below. I am versatile. You see a lot. You've also could have gotten like a very shocking vision, okay? Did you receive some sort of shocking vision in your dreams or something that you saw in plain sight? I don't know, like a UFO, an unidentified object or an unidentified spirit something, right? So this whatever you saw or you experienced, I feel like completely changed your paradigm, changed the way you look at the world, the things that you believe in, and made you even question or curious at these things. There's something here that shocked you. Where you have the ability to shock people with these powers, okay? Your name could be Destiny. You could have a channel or something called like the Lady of Light or the Lady of, if you're a female watching. I'm also getting like you have the ability to see beauty in chaos, beauty in the negativity. I'm also getting like you're somebody quite attractive, very beautiful. You can comment that down below. I am beautiful. I am a siren. Okay. You also have scrying abilities, okay? So scrying is you're able to see through a mirror, okay? Or a crystal ball, something clear here. So you work with mirrors. Maybe, like I said, this is an ability you either know you have and you're not showing, or you don't know at all and I'm activating with you right now as you're watching my video. You can see other people's reflection. You can see through other realms through the mirror, okay? You have the ability to see above and below through other realms. You can comment below, I am psychic. Like, period. Claim that shit. I am psychic. I see you're psychic here. You and your partner could both be psychic. There is a sacred union that you're meant to have here, and you're both going to have these unique abilities as well. You have the ability to manifest abundance. Your name could be Gaia. You could be a gardener. There's a lot that you're about to receive in terms of abundance here. You have some sort of gift here for others of you with the fire element. You could be a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. You're meant to have a lot of wealth and prosperity through this ability. You are a magician, very, very powerful. Something about the knowledge that you have, the books that you read, the Akashic records on your mind. I'm really getting that movie, what is it called? The Ring? The Ring? Oh, man. I wish I could remember that movie about The Ring. And I'm not talking about the horror movie. I saw 11/11. It's about a very powerful ring and whatnot. I'm forgetting it right now, even though it's one of my favorite movies, so that's lame. But yeah, you're like a wizard, a magician, a witch, a warlock, okay? You're very connected to hawks and eagles, Native American. You have a lot of assistance here, but you are a diamond, okay? Comment that down below. I am a diamond. You're somebody here meant to have a lot of wealth with this ability, my love. A lot of prosperity. Comment below. I am wealthy. I am divine. I am prosperity. My gifts will monetize abundance. Ooh, I like that. You are. You're meant to have a lot of money with this gift. But also make sure you're using your discernment. I'm also getting it's the details that you have. The details. Let's see. Tell me about this. Hold on. What was this download? You're withholding a very powerful ability. Tell me more about this message. The Sun, Leo. It's like I'm getting a whistleblower, somebody who exposes, who sheds things in the light. Okay, again, you have a very bright, abundant energy inside of you, very youthful. You have a lot of life inside of you. Ooh, somebody comment that down below. All right. I have a lot of life in me. There's a lot of life in me. Wow. Yes. Amen. Yes, there is. Ashe. The Ace of Pentacles. You are meant to be using this gift, this blessing, and showing it, revealing yourself like the sun, not hiding. The sun cannot hide. So they're showing me, no matter how much you're hiding or withholding back this gift, it's meant to shine and it's going to happen because we need the sun to survive. And the sun is going to shine every morning. So it's inevitable. It's inevitable. This is a gift from the universe to you. It was given to you since birth. Okay, I'm getting a child here. Since you were a child, this gift, this ability has been bestowed to you. It's golden. It's shiny. The Four of Swords. You're connecting with this gift while you're sleeping. It's also, I'm getting a past life gift because I just heard the word sarcophagus. Again, that Aries energy, that Emperor energy to lead. You're meant to build your own business or be a leader at this. Tell me about this unique ability. I'm getting like you could do this with your eyes closed. Whatever this ability is, you can do this shit with your eyes closed. You could be sleeping. You could be a sleeping prophet. Ooh, comment that down below. I am a sleeping prophet. Okay, like Edgar Casey. I don't know how many of you guys know about Edgar Casey. I know a few of you do because we've mentioned this before on my channel. But you're like Edgar Casey. You have an ability that when you sleep, you access the Akashic records or you see visions, you dream interpret it. I don't know. I'm hearing you do this while you sleep. Okay, the King of Cups, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. You can connect with your unconscious or other people's emotions while you're sleeping. or while they're resting, you can heal people's emotions. Maybe even you had an experience where you had somebody in your family or that you knew who was at a near death, and you helped them, you heal them in the hospital bed. I'm getting like a bed, you help them. Okay, you heal with water, or you could see like a seer with water. I'm getting you're a high priestess or a high priest. You can comment that down below. I am a high priestess. I am a high priest. But we have the Nine of Swords. It's haunting you. Because you know you're meant to use your voice. You're meant to see and show people the clarity that you see as well. But you're holding, you're fighting this gift. The Hierophant, though you're meant to be teaching this, Taurus energy, you're meant to be teaching this, you're meant to be showing this to people, guiding them, sharing the power, the knowledge, the key, speaking, okay? Either as a life coach, a public speaker, a messenger of God, a messenger of the universe, however you want to say it, however you feel it, the messenger of whatever, okay? But you are receiving a lot of blessings, and you're meant to give these messages. You are a guide. You could be like a guru, a healer, a teacher of some sort. If you're not now, this is what you're meant to be doing. And you're withholding this voice, this sword of truth, this power. And I feel like at night, it's when it either haunts you or you have nightmares about it. Something is occupying your mind that's now allowing you to just do it. What is this card, actually? I didn't see this card. The Sun Dancers. Yeah, you're meant to have a lot of abundance. And you're meant to be celebrated a lot in this lifetime. The Eight of Swords. You are holding yourself back. You are sabotaging yourself, causing your own self pain. I feel like you don't want to fail or be disappointed. But you've done this for centuries. This is something you've done. You've mastered. The Hierophant, you mastered this gift. Walk away from something painful if you have to. But the Six of Cups tells me you can help people access their memories, their Akashic records, the things that they've forgotten. I'm being pointed out as you, since a child, you've had this gift, but you are holding yourself back. You are keeping yourself in a mental prison. When you know you can free people from mental prisons, comment that down below. I can free people from mental prisons. I am free. I will free myself. I'm seeing 555. Two of Cups. Again, there's a past life connection here who you will connect with. This person's name could be Prince or last name, but I'm also getting that this person was a prince in a past life. Comes from a royal family. The Knight of Wands. It's time to take action. Make your dreams come true. Use these gifts. Because guess what, Sagittarius? Okay, some of you guys are Sagittarius. You're here to pave a new path. You're here to connect with the angels and bring these downloads. You are an earth angel. Comment that down below. I am an earth angel. You're here to restore balance. I'm also getting something about the pyramids. You know something about the pyramids of Egypt. Ace of Cups, you're chosen. You're holy. You're innocent. You're beautiful. You have an overflow of abundance and abilities inside of you. It's not just one gift. You have many gifts. And you keep holding them back. You're a high priestess. High priest. You have the Hierophant and the High Priestess here. You're quite powerful. This gift that you have, it's pretty easy for you now. And you're going to tap into it. Your soul is waiting to tap into it. The angels are communicating with you to tap into it. Open the gates and let this overflow ability. Because this is the card saying you number one. You chosen. Comment down below. I am chosen. Your Holy Spirit, whatever you want to believe in, is activating inside of you. Your name can start with a B, a J, a W, or an M, a K, an A, H, the Ace of Wands. It's time to take action and give yourself this new start to show this gift. It's time to use it. It will bring so much love to the world, is what I'm getting. It's going to bring so much healing, renewal, not just to you, but others, okay? Let's see what else is this gift that you have in here. tell me about this ability the collective is withholding here. What's my Magi gang withholding here? Blue, your throat chakra. I told you from the very beginning, it's your voice, it's your singing, it's your communication skill that you're withholding. You have a lot to say. If you have throat chakra issues, comment below. My throat chakra is healed. And hold on to it there. My throat chakra is healed. You could be 29 years old or born on the 29th. Throat chakra is communication, truth, expression. Okay? Number six, grounding, nature, stability. Again, you're meant to have a lot of abundance, wealth, prosperity in here, but if you're not grounding yourself, it's going to be hard for you to clear that smoke. Some of you guys are very practical. You have a very unique ability to communicate with nature and the birds and the trees as well. Whether this is telepathically. I also keep hearing for someone here, like, you have an ability with love to bring people together. And then I saw this card. So that was my confirmation. It says connection. You have an ability to bring people together. It's like, you know how to mate people. You could be or working as like a... You could be doing love readings, okay, like a tarot reader doing love readings, or you can actually be like a life coach, like a love coach, where that's like something you're meant to do or you're doing already. But your abilities that you're withholding right now, they're actually going to connect you to a lot of people, and you're going to connect and unite a lot of people. It's beautiful. You're connected to that conscious energy. And then we have intuition, insight. You're quite powerful. You receive insights, downloads from other realms, from the galaxies. You're receiving more and more awareness. You're becoming more awakened. Yeah, you definitely are. Look at the mind, your mind. You have the gift with, you can read telepathically. You can connect with other people's minds, with your mind. Okay? I'm also getting like, you have a big imagination, which helps you manifest. Okay? And you also have like a big mind, I'm getting, where like you can have a lot of information and you can absorb it and like learn it and remember it. Some of you guys can have photographic memory here. Your mind is opening up portals. That's your third eye, okay? Again, you can read people's minds, access their Akashic records with your eyes closed, is what I'm getting. You can speak telepathically to other galactical beings. Like, are you even hearing 2023? Are you even seeing this type of ability you have, my love? You're quite powerful. Stop withholding this power. And open yourself to it. All you have to do this is open your mind. Close your eyes and see with your heart. We have honesty, and look at the key through the throat chakra. There's a gift that you have with your voice, with your throat, with your communication. It's your honesty. It's your tea. It's the truth, the transparency. Your sincerity, the way that you communicate, that makes and brings relationships together, union, healing. You make people speak up. There's something quite unique about the way that you speak, and I feel like sometimes you know you have this key and you close yourself or you open yourself. But again, you can communicate with spirits as well, not just people. You're very good with people. You also are a Reiki healer here. Okay? You're a natural Reiki healer. Your hands are healing. You have ancient divine blood inside of you. So these powers come from your ancestry line too. Yep. You have ancient Egyptian ancestors. That's why I kept picking up those pyramids. It's time to spend time alone, okay? And connect with your traumas. Heal your traumas. Those things that trigger you in order to break free and bring in abundance of all types in your life. It's time to spend time alone. Get in a quiet space. Put some nice calming music. Light a candle to really tap into these gifts that you have. Because your mind is trying to open to the true you. Comment below. I am awakening to my true self. Wow. I am awakening to my true self. That's powerful. That deadass gave me shivers. And you're withholding these powers. Your ancestors are saying, no, it's time that you get and you use them. And they will bring you abundance. We'll give you all the wealth, all the abundance that you need. Okay, just express yourself. Share your wisdom with the world, with your community, at your school, with your family, whatever this means to you. You know what I'm saying because you're quite insightful here. But it's your time for harvest. Comment that down below. It's my time for harvest. That's what they're telling me. It's your time now to receive the abundance that you deserve, to tap into the goddess energy that you carry inside of you. There's so much that you're meant to create. You are an empress. You are a divine feminine. And your name should actually be Wisdom or the goddess or god of the hidden realms, because you can actually tap into hidden realms quite easily at any given time that you'd like. So, yeah. Some of you guys are singing. You're singers. You're dancers. Very creative. This is your gift. Your intuition is already telling you. Stop hiding it and share your voice. Okay? Share your voice. If you are having difficulty with this, comment below. I am ready to share my voice. I have a beautiful voice. Okay? My voice is healing. Yeah, you are an earth angel, baby. Comment below. I am an earth angel. You are a healer and you're going to bring a lot of love and light into this world. Like I said, you have mediumship abilities. You can speak to diseased loved ones. You can speak to the dead. You can speak to spirits. You are a powerful light worker. See? Mind you got the tea, I'm telling you. It's your throat chakra. Whoever this message is for, whoever you are, my love, it's your throat chakra. You can communicate with the dead, with the spirits. You are a medium. You are a light worker. You're quite powerful. Comment that down below. I am a powerful light worker. I am powerful. Okay? This is my message for you, my love. I hope that this can enlighten you, activate you, ground you, give you all the positivity, love, and light that you need at this time. And most importantly, encourage you to stop withholding this incredible ability that you have that we all need from you. It's time, my love. Whether you have to make it in a channel, create your own oracle deck, create a business, however it is, connect with your ancestors, ask them for knowledge. 2828 on the clock. Peace, love, and light, guys.